What is going on, guys? Grave here. Welcome back to Black Ops Cold War. And today, Activision released some information saying thanks to the players for making last week's Black Ops Cold War Alpha the most downloaded PS4 Alpha or Beta in Call of Duty history. Now, this is pretty interesting considering it seemed like the community was really torn. They either liked it or they didn't. I think a lot of people were expecting more. They're expecting more of a kind of a beta version of the game and not a true alpha. This was really a true alpha, in my opinion. It was a very early version of the game, something they put together so people could try out some things, play it, see kind of what it's like. But I think mainly what it was for Treyarch to test something. I don't know what they were trying to test. They were trying to test connections, weapons. They were trying to test something. Of course, we will get the beta here in the upcoming weeks. And the beta is going to still be an early version of the game, but the beta will be more closely linked to what you can expect from the final version of the game. Of course, there will be some things in the beta that will be changed before release, but betas are usually things that are made to be, I guess, kind of selling points for people to play it and say, you know, I want to play this, I want to buy this, that kind of thing, where alphas are more for testing for the development team. So I think a lot of people were disappointed with the alpha for wrong reasons, because maybe, you know, maybe some people really didn't just legitimately not like the game. And I think some people were expecting more because they've seen the betas that we've had in Call of Duty games in the past. But the most interesting thing out of all this is what Activision stated today, that this was the most downloaded alpha or beta for Call of Duty on PS4 in its history, which is pretty insane. That seems to happen every year, year in and year out. You'll hear, you know, this title was downloaded more than this title. This title was bought more than this title. So I am curious to see what those numbers are going to be when it comes out, when the beta is released, when the game is released, sales numbers. I'm curious to see what those numbers are. They did not give us any specific, you know, how many downloads this had, how many hours played it had. But personally, I did enjoy my experience for what it was. It was an alpha, and I did enjoy the alpha experience. Of course, now I expect more out of the beta, and I'm looking forward to it. And of course, I expect more out of the final version of the game. By no means was the alpha, you know, a real show of what the game is going to be. There was a lot of problems and bugs that persisted in this alpha, and I hope they don't kind of go over into the beta, into the final version of the game. We'll have to wait and see on that. But I was just kind of, I'm not really shocked, I guess a little bit surprised that this was the most downloaded alpha or beta in Call of Duty history, just considering that the community was really torn, like I said. A lot of people liked it, a lot of people didn't. But leave me a comment with your thoughts. What do you think about this? Were you a fan of the alpha? Are you looking forward to the beta? Are you looking forward to the release of the final game? Of course, if you like the video, hit the like. If you have not subscribed yet, please do so. If you are a subscriber, make sure you click the bell icon in the top right corner. Make sure you check out everything down in the description, GT Racing, the community Discord, and of course my Twitter. And I'll catch you next time. Peace.